หลายๆคนก็อยากมีอายุยืนและมีสุขภาพดีกว่าเดิมนะคะในโลกของวิทยาศาสตร์เนี่ยก็มีการพูดถึงไบโอแฮกกิ้งกันอยู่บ่อยๆซึ่งก็คือการใช้เทคโนโลยีชีวภาพเพื่อทำการแฮกร่างกายมนุษย์เพื่อจัดการให้ร่างกายทำงานได้มีประสิทธิภาพดียิ่งขึ้นลองไปฟังจากหนึ่งในไบโอแฮกเกอร์กันค่ะว่าสิ่งเหล่านี้ทำงานยังไง
Hi I'm Tim I'm 42 chronologically and 25 to 32 biologicallyI run one of the largest biohacking communities in the world from London. That's the form there. Most things I track every day where possible, but some things I track on a monthly basis, such as certain blood tests.
Actually, can we use the right one?
I started doing this because I got chronically sick, so I took it upon myself to start researching ways to optimize my health. I've had epigenetics tests, immune tests, hormone tests. You can see how you compare to the general population.And you can have professionals look at your data and not just rely on your own subjective experience.
มาดูกันค่ะว่าทีมต้องทำอะไรบ้างในแต่ละวัน
I start my day with natural light, blue light when there's not natural sunrise. I currently track around 50 points of data a day, a health ring which tracks my deep sleep, REM sleep, light sleep, heart rate variability, resting heart rate, respiratory rate, and body temperature.I also have one of these. If my heart has been stressed through the night, I know to have a recovery day and take it easy. Whereas if my vitals are strong, then obviously I will push on and work out harder. I track it. I track my blood glucose using a constant glucose monitor. And what that does is it tells me my response to certain foods so I can actually personalize my nutrition. Some people think it might be extreme having something in my arm all the time, but for me, living a happy, healthy life is more important than people judging me for having a few bits of tech.Here's my daily supplements here, my digestive supplements, but this is my backup drawer, my dishwasher. It is really about being the CEO of your own health. There may not be double-blind studies behind some of these things, but remember, all science is evolving. Some things do work long-term, some things don't. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy really does help the body heal.And repair properly.
So there's much more pressure in here, which means we dissolve more oxygen in the blood.
It gives me extra mental clarity, and I feel very zen in it.
You wouldn't even know that anything was happening. Occasionally your ears pop a little bit.
If I've got stuff going on and I need to chill out, then I do meditate. Sensory feedback helps me relax.
Well, it's like the perfect balance between nature and technology.
Some may say it's a contradiction of terms needing to use technology to unwind, but the point is most people use technology to unwind already. Think about Netflix.
ยังไม่หมดแค่นี้นะคะ
A typical evening for me consists of blue blocking glasses, red light when you don't get to see sunset, going digital free, and really having some time to myself.There is such a thing as too much data. You can drive yourself mad tracking too many points. Stress is bad for health, obviously, so letting go a bit is also important. If you're not sleeping well, track that. If you're bloating, track your gut bacteria. It can become a hobby, admittedly, but it's really important that you do the things that you need to do for you. Some of my colleagues would like to live to around 180. No, I want to die as young as possible, as late as possible. That's the goal.